Good morning. Please turn your TV on and channel up to channel 70. We are simulcasting on the intercom for rooms without TVs. Please stand for a Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic
for which it stands, one nation, under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please pause for a moment of silence. And now for this week's Eagle News.
Good morning, Lakeshore. It's May 28th from our PBJ studio in Lakeshore High School. This is Eagle News with Paige, Heather, and Alyssa. Now here's Paige with your morning announcements.
Good morning, Lakeshore. It's Memorial Day weekend and the weather forecast looks great. I'm Paige and here are your morning announcements. This week's featured project is a technology project by Mr. Lynn's class. It's a rustic birdhouse by Gabe K.
Attention varsity basketball cheerleaders. Please return your uniforms now in order to try out for next year. Ms. Henry needs all uniforms ASAP. Cheerleading tryouts for the 2010 football season will begin Monday, June 7th to Wednesday, June 9th. Pick up tryout packets in room 237. Today is the last day to get your yearbook tickets in front of the cafeteria during lunches. If you have already purchased a book, make sure to get your ticket. No ticket, no book. If you have not yet purchased a yearbook, you may do so. The cost is $70 and checks should be made payable to Shorelines.
Attention seniors, today is the last day to pay for your cap and gown. The cost is $10. Please see Ms. Paskowitz in the main office. If you are 18 years old and have your New York State driver's license, you may be eligible for a job at CLADA. Please see Mr. Kelly for details. That's it for this week's announcements. Now let's head over to Alyssa with this week's Eagle Extra.
After a year of hard work, the AP Calculus class went to SUNY Fredonia last Friday for a fun day at the annual Math and Science Challenge. The theme of this year's competition was I Love the 90s. And while this year's class made t-shirts, their fellow competitors dressed like up like Madonna, Spice Girls, and other popular 90s bands. The day started with a game of 90210, named for the popular 90s TV show, a version of Madness which you may have played in your math classes. After shouting Luke Perry is cool when they received the answer, one Lakeshore team made it to the final round of the game, coming just short of a victory. The class then split into groups of four or five to compete in even smaller events. One event was Wide Right and No Goal. The team had to build a tower of common objects like newspaper and straws to support trophies, as a monument to the almost success of Buffalo sports teams. Other games included Richard Simmons Celebrity Fit Club, Tetris Geometry, Boy Band Challenge, and Saved by the Bell Trivia. The groups then went on to compete in many Minute to Win It games. They had to answer math questions for a chance to do fun challenges like a dance-off, pulling tissues out of a box of tissues the fastest, and fanning balloons into squares on the other side of the room. The AP Calc students competed hard, and although they did not win any trophies, they did win second in the dance-off in 90210. They certainly had fun, and juniors should look forward to going next year.
This week, some Lakeshore students played a variation of the game Name That Tune. Here's Bob to tell us more in this week's Random Acts segment.
Hi, I'm Bob with Eagle News, and I'm here in the hallways to see if you know that song backwards. Let's see.
Is that MGMT? I said MGMT.
Oh, it's Hey Soul Sister, right? Yeah. Sounds cool. I don't know what this is.
Either! One more time.
What is it?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay.
One more time.
Thanks, guys. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Bob. Who knew Nick was such a great dancer? It's time for a look at Eagle Sports. Paige has the details.
The boys' varsity tennis team had a strong effort in the ECIC Team Championship playoffs this week. The team defeated Tonawanda 5-0, but lost to the top-ranked Clarence team 1-4 in the pool play. Double winners for the Eagles were John W. and Connor G. Other winners included Ricky S., Alex S., Drew C., Chad C., and Lucas M. The team finished the season with an impressive 10-6 overall record. The boys' varsity baseball team lost 5-4 on Tuesday to Will East on a walk-off home run, ending the season. The boys' varsity lacrosse team suffered a defeat Tuesday night under the lights 14-8 against West Seneca East. The girls' varsity softball team won Wednesday 5-2 against Albion. The girls' varsity lacrosse team put up a great fight but lost their game Wednesday night 11-5 against West Seneca East, finishing their season by compiling a great record along the way. That's all for school sports. Now let's turn it over to regional. In this week's regional sports action, the Buffalo Bisons played at home yesterday and have another home game tonight at 7:05. The Bisons also have home games tomorrow, Sunday, and Monday. Every game counts as the much-improved team is just one game out of first place. For all you hockey fans, Stanley Cup Finals begin tomorrow at 8 p.m. The Philadelphia Flyers, including former Buffalo Sabre Daniel Briere, will take on South Buffalo's Patrick Kane and the Chicago Blackhawks. The men's NCAA lacrosse Final Four is getting underway. The competing teams will be Virginia, Duke, Cornell, and Notre Dame. And this weekend, don't just watch sports. Play some beach volleyball, backyard ball, or head over to a basketball court with some friends. That's all for Eagle Sports this week. Now let's see what else we can do to get off that couch.
Looking for something fun and exciting to do this weekend? Darien Lake is now open. Season passes range from $55 to $60, and one-day admission tickets costing $40. Enjoy the thrill of the Superman, the Ride of Steel, or roller coasters aren't your thing. The weather is just right for a water park for you and your friends to splash in. This weekend, Connors at the Sturgeon Point Marina opens for the summer. Finally, with a nice weather forecast, why not head to the beach or local park? State parks will be open this weekend. It's time for this week's Words of Wisdom. Here's Heather.
Listen up, girls. This one's for you. Former First Lady Barbara Bush is well known for her sense of humor. In June of 1990, she addressed the all-female graduating class of Wesleyan College with these words: "Who knows, someone who will one day follow in my footsteps and preside over the White House as the president's spouse, and I will wish him well."
Look around, girls. Maybe you're sitting right next to a future female president.
With something to think about, this is Heather. Make it a great day or not, the choice is yours. Bye.